Hi, my name is Brian Bezik. I'm a practicing PA in pulmonary medicine just outside of Boise, Idaho. I work for the Terry Riley Health Centers. I'm excited to bring you this video on COPD. COPD is something I treat every day, and I know many of you do as well. COPD is chronic obstructive pulmonary disease. The chronic, it's every day. Obstruction, difficulty getting air out, difficulty exhaling in a way that can keep up with daily activities. COPD is all too common, and it doesn't just affect the lungs. COPD has effects on almost every body system, specifically our cardiovascular system. COPD can adversely affect most things that can affect the heart too. When we think about COPD, we think about inflammation, chronic inflammation as part of the chronic obstructive process. Type 1 and type 2 inflammation are pretty familiar to us, but I want to review them real quick. Type 1 is the inflammation we usually associate with COPD. It's the part of our immune system that handles incoming pathogens and other things, but think about bacteria, virally infected cells. We need that type 1 inflammation to address those insults. Type 2 is a little different. We think of type 2 with allergies and asthma, and that's appropriate. The cells and mediators of type 2 inflammation often drive asthma symptoms and allergy symptoms. But what role do they have with COPD? This isn't a part of COPD, is it? Well, it turns out it can be a very significant part for many of our patients. Up to 40% of our patients that we see with COPD have type 2 inflammation playing a significant role. With type 2 inflammation, patients are more likely to have exacerbations. The ones they have are more likely to be severe. Greater mucus production, greater inflammation, more mucus plugging. All these things can be a part of increased type 2 inflammation. When we think about type 2 inflammation, there are some powerful cells and mediators behind all of this. The cells include mast cells and eosinophils. The interleukins, these are powerful cytokines that drive many of the symptoms we see. Interleukins 4, 5, and 13 all play a significant role. They are the drivers of the symptoms our patients present with. That's kind of the bad news. The good news is that patients with elevated type 2 inflammation, again, up to 40% of those COPD patients that we see have this, they do tend to respond better to both inhaled and oral corticosteroids. Those patients just have a more robust response because type 2 inflammation is responsive to steroids. The other very promising thing is that we now have two biologics that are approved for treating COPD, and they go after those interleukins and that inflammation, that type 2 inflammation. We're going to take a deeper dive into both exacerbations, inflammation, and type 2 inflammation in our next video. Stay tuned.